Installing Historian for the first time? Hi, I'm Kathleen. I'm a tech writer here at GE Digital, and I'm going to walk you through the installation process. Historian software is supported on the following Windows operating systems. In this video, we'll be installing Historian on Windows Server 2019. Before we begin, you need to do a few things. First, log on to your computer as an administrator. Confirm that you aren't logged in via RDP or a terminal server session. And finally, make sure there are no other GE processes running. Let's get started. Double-click the Historian ISO file to open the install media. Be aware that this file name may change depending upon the current version number. From the install media, you're going to right-click the install launcher.exe, and you're going to select Run as Administrator. If a message appears with a security warning, you click to proceed. From the install screen, now you're just going to select Install Historian. So click Next. Select Accept, and then Next to continue. And you're going to leave the default right here, and then click Next. Again, leave the defaults, and click Next. And then on the Security Groups page, you're going to leave this checkbox cleared, and then click Next. Leave the default Historian Single Server selected, and then click Next. And then you're going to click Install. Now just wait a few moments as the server installs, and then you're going to click Exit when the successful installation screen appears. And then click Yes to restart your computer. This may take several minutes, and after your computer restarts, the Historian installation process will be complete. After the restart, you're going to want to open the Windows Services Console app to confirm that the Historian Data Archiver shows up in the Services panel and is in a running state. So, like this. Data Archiver is an important application that needs to be running for use of the Historian server, and you're not going to be able to get data in iFix if the Historian Data Archiver is not installed and running. So this is why we just check to make sure that it's running here. Next, you need to perform the post-installation tasks. So see the next video in this series. And this concludes our walkthrough. Thank you for watching.